this morning. We'll see you soon. And thank you. That was AM Early. Thanks to our partner, Milford Asset Management. It is now coming up to 4 minutes away from 6 o'clock.
Monday the 23rd of January, you're with AM. It is wonderful to be back with you. I'm sure a lot of you have been back at work already. And thanks so much to our partners, Mazda.
Yeah, very cool to have Mazda on board. And good morning, everybody. It is great to be back. I'm sorry we took so long. Honestly, the messages I've had on social media, where are you? Why are you guys having such a long summer? I was in Whangamatara a couple of weeks ago, and this woman, I think she might have had a few rosés in the sun, came running up to me and she said, you guys just take too long on holiday. In our defence, it's not us that decides how long the break is. It's the people upstairs. So.
But in all fairness, come on, you deserve a long break. Waking up in these crazy hours and doing it for the whole entire year.
It's not the hardest job compared to a lot of people, but that's nice of you to say, Oriini, and welcome to you.
You'll
notice that Bern isn't here this morning. She's doing really well, but she's still recovering, and we'll have a little bit more on that after seven. Now, speaking of your break, for anyone who missed this on social media, feast your eyes.
This is the photo
on this. Ryan.
You shouldn't put this on the TV. This is a very social media photo.
How was your holiday at Club Tropicana?
Clearly, it was pretty good. That's in my friend's pool, by the way, not my pool. It's also before the severe weight gain that was to come after it. That was early on in the summer. No, it was a great summer. That was New Year's Day, actually. I'm surprised I was
I'm surprised you were alive.
How was your trip, Mel?
Yeah, it was really good. So we went over to the UK. We didn't catch anything on the plane, which I was kind of worried about, as you do. But about a week or so into it, I got really quite sick and was out in bed, stuck in bed for about 5 days. It was interesting because I did go to an emergency centre at one point over there, and the wait time was 7 hours at least. I went to another one, it was 5. So these are hospital pressures, certainly not isolated to New Zealand. It was kind of a scary thing. I thought, well, how sick do I need to be able to get some help? Because obviously I just walked out, I thought, I'm pregnant, I'm not sitting in an emergency room for 7 hours.
But don't you play the pregnancy card? Can you not push it out?
I did.
To the front?
That didn't work.
Really?
Yeah, I also had my son with me who was really sick as well. I said, I'm pregnant, my son is 3, we're both really unwell. And they said, you've got a 7 hour wait until triage.
Wow. I would have thought being pregnant with a toddler in tow would get you
you'd think so.
Right to the front of the line. You should have taken grandma along or something.
I didn't turn on the tears enough, maybe.
All right. Well, we have had a great summer, and we look forward to sharing this year with you. It's, of course, an election year, so there is a lot going to be happening on this program. We've got all and sundry on the show this morning as well. Send us a message. Tell us how your summer has been. feedback@aimshow.co.nz. We'd love to hear from you this morning. Right, it is 6 o'clock now coming up. It's the battle of the Chrises this election. So who will get your vote? National leader Chris Luxon and incoming Prime Minister Chris Hipkins are with us live in studio after seven.
Are you worried about your child's reading progress at school? We discuss proposed changes to how reading is going to be taught in schools. That's just after eight.
It's been a shocking summer at our beaches with 6 deaths in Auckland over the last 4 days. We talked to a survivor about her experience surviving. Shortly.
And fresh details have been released about the King's coronation. We're live to the UK with Lisette Raymer just after 6:30. Right now, here's Oriini with your news.
At the Māori Aotearoa, a gunman remains on the run after killing at least 10 people and injuring 10 others in a mass shooting at a dance studio in Los Angeles. Based on preliminary descriptions, police are hunting for an Asian male who is believed to have opened fire shortly after 10 p.m. local time.